Welcome to you to Chem Help ASAP. Let's discuss the common bases that are used for E2 reactions. So to do an E2 reaction, the key idea is we need a base. And how do you identify a base? Well, bases, they're going to remove protons, remove hydrogens. They are almost always, or they are always, electron rich. How can you tell something's electron rich? Almost all electron-rich things are anions. Now, if this sounds like a discussion about nucleophiles for the SN2 reaction where we look for anions, you're right, it is. And if that seems like it might be a problem, you're right, it is. But for now, let's focus on the E2 reactions and bases, because the fact is, good bases are almost always anions. So what are the most common bases? Well, if I said to you, name a strong base, a lot of people are going to say sodium hydroxide. And that's correct. Sodium hydroxide is a great base to use for an E2 reaction. And it's because we have sodium plus and this nice reactive, unstable, basic O minus. And of course, we can use potassium hydroxide just the same. There's nothing special about sodium hydroxide. Potassium hydroxide works great as well. What are the other bases? Well, sometimes in organic chemistry, we need organic bases, bases that have some organic structure to them for solubility reasons and other purposes. So we run into the alkoxides. And what are the common alkoxides? One is methoxide, where it's a methyl group on our O minus. And sometimes people will write CH3 or they'll write ME for methyl. You can also use ethoxide. It's an O minus with, instead of methyl, it's an ethyl chain. And you might just write ET instead for ethoxide, another alkyl oxide. And then finally, another real common one is t-butoxide. So sodium t-butoxide, where we put a t-butyl group on our oxygen. And normally people won't write down the full structure, but you know, we can. NaO, that's going to be a C with three CH3s coming off of that carbon. So this is one way to draw it as TBU. Sometimes people will draw the line angle structure and they write this cross because there's a carbon and three methyl groups coming off of it. That's T-butoxide or tert-butyl oxide. That's another alkoxide. Less common, but sometimes encountered, are amine bases. We know ammonia is a base. It's not an anion, but it is electron-rich. That nitrogen has a lone pair. And so these are two common bases you'll encounter. And so this base in particular, people might write it as triethyl amine. And you might see that here and there as you encounter different E2 reactions. However, I would say by far the most common base you will encounter is going to fall in this table. Sodium hydroxide, the methoxide, ethoxide, or t-butoxide will be used for bases in the E2 reaction.